It's longer than 8 meters, and it appears to be harmless, but really, what is it? Does it eat people? These questions didn't seem to bother the divers, who gently swam around it while the creature pulsated and floated beside them. Well, they were right not to fear it. This is not a giant man-eating worm. It's a pyrosome, and it eats plankton and algae. So, what is a pyrosome? Well, it's more than meets the eye. Each pyrosome is not a single creature. Instead, a pyrosome is a colony made up of many individual creatures that are just a few millimeters long, all of them joined by a jelly-like membrane. The tiny creatures that make up a whole pyrosome can number in the hundreds or even the thousands. Some pyrosomes are only 1 centimeter long, while others can grow up to 18 meters. While pyrosomes have funny nicknames like sea pickles and unicorns of the sea, their Greek name literally means fire bodies. That's because these creatures are bioluminescent, which means that they make light. At night, many sailors have observed groups of pyrosomes lighting up the deep waters with their beautiful colors. Scientists know that dolphins and whales eat pyrosomes, but we're not sure about the role that pyrosomes play in the sea. But they do know that pyrosomes have suddenly become plentiful. The warmer waters of climate change are causing a sea pickle population explosion. While that may sound funny, they are affecting their fellow sea creatures and ultimately us. Right now, we don't know too much about how they affect the food web. We do know that the sudden increase in pyrosomes is affecting fishing on the west coast of the United States. Pyrosomes have broken fishing nets, and fishermen are finding more pyrosomes than the salmon and shrimp that they're trying to catch. Currently, researchers at the University of Oregon and the Northwest Fisheries Science Center are studying pyrosomes and how their population growth is affecting their surroundings. Pyrosomes usually live in tropical waters, but for several years, they've been living in the eastern Pacific Ocean, and they're showing up in huge numbers. Some fishermen have stopped fishing in areas from Oregon to Alaska. Those fishing spots used to be free of pyrosomes. As scientists try to figure out the impact that large numbers of pyrosomes have on ecosystems, fisheries are trying to figure out the economic impact that these creatures will have. Lighting up the sea and exploding in numbers. That's what pyrosomes do. And that's what makes them crazy creatures.